You might think that electrical codes are out there for everyone's safety, and maybe to save some insurance company payouts. Not necessarily. Sometimes, as is often the case with bureaucracy, regulations are added to make someone some money. Today we're going to look at an efficient and economical way to wire light switches that has been done away with so that you might purchase fancier devices, which will most certainly fail long before the devices they're designed to replace. Once upon a time, it was common practice to run power directly to a light fixture box and then run a switch loop to the switch itself. This was almost always faster and almost always used less wire. You could pull a run from the electrical panel in and out of every light box, then simply drill and drop a cable from each light box to each switch box. Simple, clean, effective. What has changed? Manufacturers started making smart switches. Smart. These are the switches with the bells and whistles. Switches that can work remotely or with voice activation or can be pre-programmed to do a variety of things, with the caveats that none of these things are necessary, nor do they make your house safer. Two things most people would think are required for legislation. But electrical manufacturers lobbied for a change in the electrical code so that they could sell more devices. And they won. It became legislated luxury. Kind of like saying in order to sell sofas, they must have built-in recliners, just in case someone in the future wants to recline. Are recliners nice? Yes. Are they necessary? No. Will they require more raw materials and labor and ultimately raise the price of sofas? Yes. Would recliner hardware manufacturers love to mandate recliners in all sofas? Absolutely. Well, that's basically how it went with the wiring code. So what is this luxury electrical code that I'm making such a big deal about? 404.2C. The grounded circuit conductor for the controlled lighting circuit shall be installed at the location where switches control lighting loads. For us everyday folks, that basically means a neutral wire, typically the white wire, is required at every switch location, with a few exceptions. Why do smart switch manufacturers want a neutral at every switch location? Because a neutral at every switch location is required to complete the circuit to these luxury switches. I know some people are thinking, why does he keep calling them luxury switches? A luxury is something that is nice to have, but is not necessary. You do the math. So why am I about to show you how to make an illegal switch setup? Because A, if you have an older home, you almost certainly have some of these switch setups. And if you DIY, you'll probably want to know how they work. And B, some people just like information that could be useful to them one day. And in my opinion, knowing how to do a switch loop is very useful information. And if things get crazy and you need to patch some things together quickly with limited resources, you'll have more options. Also, while I was actually editing this video, someone asked the question, what if I have a ceiling fan that's directly wired and there's no switch? How do I add a switch? Switch loop. And then that got me to thinking there are probably a lot of people out there that have pull chain lights, maybe in a closet or a utility room or a laundry room or something like that, and they would like to turn it into a switch light. Then this video is for you. Now remember, electricity can hurt or even kill you, so I'm not recommending you try any of this on your own. I'm just sharing information. If you saw my switches simplified video, you'll already know how switches work. If you don't know how switches work, you might want to go check out that video. It's been called one of the best switch videos. In a switch loop setup, you bring power directly into the light fixture box from its source, whether it be a junction box or the electrical panel itself, instead of into the switch box first. Then you send that power down to the switch and back up to the fixture in a loop. So here's your light fixture. And here's the power coming in, hot, live power. We'll go ahead and connect our neutral to the light fixture because neutrals always go directly to the light. They are never involved in a switch. Now we have our hot conductor left. And obviously, if we went ahead and connected this together here, the light would be on all the time. And in most cases, we're not going to want that. We know that switches are designed to connect and disconnect the hot wire. So how do we throw a switch into this scenario? We'll just extend these two wires down to the switch. We'll send the power down to the switch on this white wire, which we'll relabel as black since it will now be hot. Then we'll bring our power back up to the light on this black wire. We do it this way instead of vice versa because we almost always want there to be an obvious black wire and white wire in the light fixture box to make it easier to change out fixtures. So let's go through this one more time. We have the power coming into the light box from our power source, which could be the panel or a junction box. The neutral goes directly to the light, as always, never involved in the switch. The hot goes to the switch via the white conductor relabeled black and returns the loop through the black conductor to the light itself. And of course, all of our grounds are connected. That's it. So let's see if it works. Switch loop setups almost always use less wire because you don't have multiple cables running to and from the same boxes. And they are usually faster and easier to install because you just need to run power in and out of every light box and then simply drop your switch loop wire down to each switch. So they conserve copper and labor, both which conserve your hard-earned money. So if you enjoyed or learned something from this video, please consider hitting the like button. The next electrical video is going to be how to do switch loops with three-way switches. So if you're interested in that and you haven't subscribed yet, you might want to think about doing that. And as always, thank you for watching. Please comment below, and I hope to see y'all in the next one. This is the first. Never seen anybody. Hi there, Pitbull.